Hello everyone, I am Sudhita Barik from National Law University, Odisha. I am offering a paper on consumer laws and RTI and Odisha State Open University. So before going to the content of consumer laws and RTI, first we'll deal with the Consumer Protection Act and then we'll go with the RTI, Right to Information Act 2005. So as we have already discussed in the introduction video about the learning objectives and what we will be discussing on the topic, so just to relate to the previous video, introductory video, I'll give you a straight direct introduction of the Act. The Consumer Protection Act provides and protects the interest of the consumers. At the same time, it establishes consumer councils to mediate the consumer issues or consumer disputes. Apart from that, it establishes special forum courts according to the pecuniary jurisdiction, according to the compensation. So before we go to the defect in goods and deficiency in services, we need to know the rights. Rights. What are the rights that are provided under Consumer Protection Act 1986? That are six rights provided under the Consumer Protection Act. Right to be informed, right to grievance redressal, right to consumer education, right to be informed, right to be heard, right to consumer education. So all these rights are provided. So before we get the right or to perform the responsibilities, we need to understand who is a consumer first. So as you can refer to my transcript, it is already written the complete definition under the Consumer Protection Act under section 1D of Consumer Protection Act 1986, which says about who is the consumer. Now the term who is a consumer is divided into two types under the section 2.1d of the Consumer Protection Act, where in one part it says consumer who purchases the goods and in the other part it says the person who hires or avail the services. So I want to clear it, what is a consumer who buys the goods and the consumer who hires or avail the services. Now the person who consumes the goods or who purchases the good, that will come under defect in goods. And the person who avails or hires the services, that will come under deficiency in services. So I'll make you understand about the who is a consumer with one important landmark case of 1994, Lucknow Development Authority versus M.K. Gupta, AIR 1994, Supreme Court 787. So in this case, the Supreme Court has held that consumer is a comprehensive term. So all the person cannot be considered as a consumer. So to be a consumer has to qualify certain criteria. Now who can be considered as a consumer? The person who buys eatable goods, or the person who buys goods for his personal use, or the person who buys goods or commodities for any private use, those persons are considered as consumers. But the goods or services that is offered or purchased for commercial purpose, that cannot be considered as a consumer, or they will not be considered as a consumer. Again, one important thing in the definition of consumer, how there is one important concept that is coming under the definition of consumer is consideration. Consideration means when you are paying something, or you are paying, or you are purchasing the good, in return you are paying the price. Now how you will pay the price? Now again, the price has been divided under the consumer definition into four types. Now one is which has been paid or promised to be paid, partly paid or partly promised, or under deferred payments. Now in this four categories, it is provided that when you are paying something incomplete, you can be considered as a consumer. When you are paying partly and other you are promised to be the other part you are promising to pay in future, that can be also considered under the definition of consumer. Another is when you are partly paying but you are not paying the half of the thing, maybe under any other provision under the contract or any other thing, that can be also considered as a consumer under the consideration. You are paying something partly or fully you are paying. Another is the deferred payment. The last one is the deferred payment. Now deferred payment means if you are paying for the commodity in installments, but the payment has to be complete. So that is one of the things where and which includes under the definition of consumer, to know that whether you are coming under the definition of consumer or not. Now if the commodity is purchased free of cost, then that is not coming under the definition of consumer. Under the definition of consumer, under Consumer Protection Act 1986, there is another term or another concept that is mentioned is user of goods. Now, whether the user of goods will be considered under the definition of consumer or not, we can cite the Donoghue versus Stevenson case where it says that a stranger cannot be sued under Indian Contract Act, but a stranger can be sued under Consumer Protection Act. So whenever a consumer is considered, whenever a person is using a product and he is paying for that and he is considered as the user of the good and he is the stranger to a contract, then that person can also be considered as a consumer under Consumer Protection Act. Then directly we'll come to the two of the exceptions of the consumer. Then now, what are the two categories where the under the definition of consumer they are not considered, or they can't file an application, or they can't file a complaint under the Consumer Protection Act? Now, two exceptions are given under the Consumer Protection Act under Section 2(1)(d), which says that resale and commercial purpose. Now, the person or a person who is purchasing the goods for resale purpose, giving consideration, it means giving money and paying money and purchasing the goods for resale purpose, they cannot be considered as a consumer. Second is commercial purpose. Now, the person who is purchasing goods or commodities or items for commercial purpose, for example, for any commercial purpose, again, that depends upon the facts and circumstances of the case, how a commercial purpose is decided by the courts or the quasi-judicial authorities. Now, commercial purpose, now, in some cases, if it is purchased for commercial purpose also, that is considered as a consumer. For example, a person is purchasing a generator, or the person is purchasing a Xerox machine for his livelihood. That is called the self-employment. Now, that person can be considered under the definition of consumer. Now, for example, a person is purchasing 10 trucks for transportation services or for transportation business, then that cannot be considered as a consumer because that is used for commercial purpose. So then it depends upon the facts and circumstances of the case where it is considered. In some cases, it is considered as it will not be included under the definition as a consumer. In some cases, it is considered. It is considered that it is for the self-employment and he is considered to be a consumer. Then we'll come to the second important provision, that is the services. Now, services, again, how we will be seeing deficiency in services. Now, section 2(1) says about services. What types of services can be questioned or can be termed as the deficiency in services? Now, deficiency of services, again, the same provisions apply. Partially promised to be paid or partly paid, paid in deferred payments, partly paid and partly promised. So those are similar with the defect in goods and deficiency in services. Apart from that, if the services are rendered free of charge, then that cannot be questioned, that cannot include under the definition of consumer. And another important thing under services, under the definition of service, the Consumer Protection Act provides is under a contract of personal service. Now, if for example, a person is working under a personal services, for example, you can say a housemaid, or any person is working under any personal capacity where there is no contract, or under personal mutual faith or fiduciary relationship a person is working, then again that cannot be considered as a consumer. Then next come to the beneficiary of services. Now, who is the beneficiary? Whether the beneficiary can be considered as a consumer or not. Now, beneficiary, we can take the example of the case study, which is very landmark case study, Spring Meadows Hospital versus Hans Joel Aluwalia, AIR 1998, Supreme Court 1801, where it is said that a minor patient is considered as a beneficiary to the services. Now, for example, the parents of a minor child have done a medical policy. Now, when they have done a medical policy, whether the minor is considered as a consumer or not, because the contract was between the parents and the institution, insurance institution. So, whether that person will be considered as a consumer or not. Now, when a person is dependent, when a minor son or daughter is a dependent to his parents, he is called as the beneficiary to the services. And impliedly, the person or the minor child is considered as the beneficiary to the service. As per the Consumer Protection Act or the Spring Meadows Hospital, the Supreme Court has held that he or she can be considered, or any dependent to the parents can be considered as a beneficiary to the service. So this is all about the definition of consumer definition of consumer. So if you go through the transcript, there are many illustrations and decided cases have been given where you can clarify or understand who can be considered as a consumer and who can't be considered as the consumer. So we'll discuss the next commercial purpose in the next video. Thank you.